I'm really, really tired of manipulation. I'm tired of how the press is manipulating everything that's been happening in this situation. They will not tell the truth. They lie. The minute it became the all-time best-selling album in the history of the Guinness Book of World Records, overnight, they called me a freak. They called me a homosexual. They called me a child molester. They said I tried to bleach my skin. They made everything to turn the public against me. This is all complete, complete conspiracy. You have to know that.
Album's number one all over the world. All over the world. America's the only one because I don't want to say too much.
But it's not number one in the United States.
It's conspiracy, yeah. I don't want to say too much. I'm done. They did it to try and belittle me, to try to take away my pride. But I went through the whole system with them, and at the end, I wanted the public to know that I was okay, even though I was hurting.
What happened when they arrested you? What did they do to you?
They were supposed to go in and just check fingerprints and do the whole thing that they do when they take somebody in. They manhandled me very roughly. My shoulder is dislocated, literally. It's hurting me very badly. I'm in pain all the time. See this arm? This is as far as I can reach it. Same with this side over here.
Because of what happened at the police station?
Yeah, at the police station. And what they did to, if you saw what they did to my arms, it was very bad what they did. It was very swollen. I want to say,
but how
you'll see.
We were given this photograph said to be taken after Michael Jackson was released on bail. Jackson says the swelling above his wrist is where the police handcuffed him.
With the handcuffs, the way they tied them too tight behind my back. Yeah, and they put it in a certain position knowing that it's going to hurt and affect my back. Now I can't move. It keeps me from sleeping at night. I can't sleep at night. One time I asked to use the restroom, and they said, sure, it's right around the corner there. Once I went in the restroom, they locked me in there for like 45 minutes. There was doo-doo feces thrown all over the walls, the floor, the ceiling, and it stunk so bad. Then one of the policemen came by the window, and he made a sarcastic remark. He said, does it smell good enough for you in there? How do you like the smell? Is it good? And I just simply said, it's all right. It's okay. So I just sat there and waited.
I will say that I am particularly upset by the handling of this mass matter by the incredible, terrible mass media. I ask all of you to wait and hear the truth before you label or condemn me. Don't treat me like a criminal, because I am innocent. They served a search warrant on me, which allowed them to view and photograph my body, including my penis, my buttocks, my lower torso, thighs, and any other area that they wanted. They were supposedly looking for any discoloration, spotting, blotches, or other evidence of a skin color disorder called vitiligo, which I have previously spoken about. And if I failed to cooperate with them, they would introduce that refusal at any trial as an indication of my guilt. It was the most humiliating ordeal of my life, one that no person should ever have to suffer. And even after experiencing the indignity of this search, the parties involved were still not satisfied and wanted to take even more pictures. It was a nightmare, a horrifying nightmare. But if this is what I have to endure to prove my innocence, my complete innocence, so be it.
Thank you.
Now the plot to destroy Michael Jackson. Another young boy coming forward with allegations he was molested by the superstar. But when our Diane Dimond began to investigate, she uncovered a trail of lies.
I just had to go to Canada and check it out myself.
And I'd like to make a confession about something that happened between me and Michael Jackson.
He is only 15 years old, so we can't show you his face or let you hear his real name. But the 11-minute home video he sent hard copy several weeks ago could have become Michael Jackson's worst nightmare. Looking straight into the camera, using no notes, this boy proceeded to tell us in graphic detail how he and another teen were allegedly molested by the superstar. But the boy wasn't acting on his own. He had help. A man who identified himself as John Templeton of Mississauga, Canada. That's a suburb of Toronto. He sent us the boy's videotape statement and even called several times to make sure we looked at it. Later, he would draw us incredibly detailed maps of both Jackson homes. It was clear either the boy was telling the truth or he had been well coached. To get to the bottom of it, I agreed to meet the boy and John Templeton in Toronto. The plan was to meet the pair in the lobby of an airport hotel, but when I arrived, the only one to greet me was the young boy. He came with me into town and told me that he lived on the streets of Toronto. John Templeton was just a man he'd met on the streets.
He talked for hours, and he knew so much. So much, in fact, that we thought, well, let's give him a test, you know, to see if we could trip him up.
We showed the boy several photographs. Some of them were of Neverland employees, and he was able to identify each and every one of them. We delivered the boy to the Toronto Metro Police Headquarters, where detectives from the Sexual Assault Unit had been waiting for us.
I understand you want to speak to me.
But there was one thing I didn't tell the boy. I didn't tell him that for the last year, I've been getting Michael Jackson-related letters from his same small suburb in Canada. The letters were supposedly from other young boys who also claimed that they had been molested by Jackson. Two of the letters even included pictures of the boys. Well, someone was behind all this, but still, there was no sign of the man who'd sent us the original video statement of the boy. No sign of John Templeton. We drove out to the Toronto suburbs to check out the return address from the videotape he sent us. That's when we ran into somebody we knew.
What the hell is going on?
Okay, Diane, let me explain something to you.
Say hello to John Templeton, only his real name is Rodney Allen. We've known about Rodney for a long time. Right after the Michael Jackson scandal first broke, he was on the phone to us claiming that another Jackson family member had molested him years ago. Rodney has never offered any solid proof of this claim. He appeared to be a man bent on revenge. And Rodney admitted he was the one who'd been writing me all those letters.
I care about this one kid who gave me all sorts of information about Neverland, about Havenhurst, about Disneyland, about Michael Jackson's body. Where did he get all that information?
He got it from me.
You planted all this stuff in this kid's head.
I didn't find it in his head. He was asking questions. I answered them as best I can. I told him what I could doubt about the place. Because I want Michael to face it.
So this kid is a A1, number one liar.
The whole story was a scam. A Toronto street kid meets a man obsessed with the Michael Jackson case, and the result could have been an international scandal. Meanwhile, back at the police station, the boy finally broke down. He admitted that he and Rodney Allen had made up the whole story. The young boy was lying.
That's my belief, and as a result of that, he was charged, yes.
This man is going to be humiliated beyond belief.
Yeah.
He will not believe it. He will not believe what's going to happen to him.
Yeah.
Beyond his worst nightmares, sell one more record.
If I go through with this, I win big time. I will get everything I want. They will be destroyed forever.